Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to discuss Chebyshev's theorem. There are procedures to measure the relation between the mean and the standard deviation. The mean is the measure of centrality of a set of observations and the standard deviation is the measure of the spread . There are two general rules. That establish a relationship between these measures and the set of observations. The first is called the Chebyshev's theorem and the second is empirical rule. And now we shall study Chebyshev's theorem in detail. Chebyshev's theorem applies to any distribution regardless of shape and it places lower limits on the percentages of observations within a given number of standard deviations from the mean . The Chebyshev's theorem established the following rules. 1. At least 3/4 of the observations in a set will lie within 2 standard deviations of the mean. And 2. At least 8/9 of the observations in a set will lie within 3 standard deviations of the mean. In general, Chebyshev's theorem states that at least 1 minus 1 upon k square of the elements of any distribution lies within k standard deviations . of the mean, where k is a number greater than or equal to 1, we can explain this in another way, that Chebyshev shows that for any number k greater than 1, the probability that a value of a given random variable will be within k standard deviations of the mean is at least 1 minus 1 upon k squared. Here we take an example. We have stock prices that last 35 days as follows. Now we have step-by-step instructions for calculating variance and standard deviation. First we calculate the mean x bar. Second, write a table that subtracts the mean from each observed value. Then list x observations mean, that is x bar, x minus x bar and x minus x bar the whole square. Next we square each of the differences. That is x minus x bar the whole square. Then we add x minus x bar the whole square column and then divide by n minus 1, where n is the number of items in the sample. This is the variance. And in order to calculate standard deviation, take the square root of the variance. Now using the above instructions, the sample mean is calculated as that is x bar is given by 4.4286. That is, we have taken the sum of all the prices and divided it by 35. Variance is given by 4.1933 and standard deviation is equal to 2.0478. Thus we have found the mean, that is 4.4286, and the standard deviation, that is 2.0478. It means that for this study we have 4.4286 minus of 2.0478, which is equal to 2.0478. 2.3808 and 4.4286 plus 2.0478, which is equal to 6.4764. In this instance, the price of the stock ranges from 2.38 to 6.48. Therefore, based on Chebyshev's theorem, it indicates that at least 3/4 of the observations in a set will lie within the interval mean plus minus of 2 into standard deviation . Now, for the value of k is equal to 2, we have 1 minus 1 upon k square, which is equal to 1 minus 1 upon 2 square, that is 1 minus 1 upon 4, which is equal to 4 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4, which is equal to 0.75. This is interpreted that at least 0.75 of the observations will fall between 2 and plus 2 standard deviations. Furthermore, we calculate 4.4286 plus minus of 2 into 2.0478, which are defined by the points 0.333 and 8.5242. Thus, we can say that at least 75% of the stock prices paid between 0.33 and 8.5. And a review of the data set shows that one observation, that is 0.333, lies outside this range of values. Since there are 35 observations in the set, 33 out of 35 are within the specified range, so the rule that at least 3/4 will be within the range is satisfied. This computation indicates that at least 75% of the data lies within 75% of the mean . In the above example, we can say that at least 75% of the stocks purchased are at least within 2 standard deviations of the mean. Similarly, calculation can be made using 3 standard deviations. Let us take another example. Suppose we ask 1000 people what their age is. If this is a representative sample, then there will be very few people of 1 to 2 years old, just as there will not be many 95-year-olds. Most will have an age somewhere in their 30s or 40s. A list of the number of people of a certain age may look like this. Next, we can turn this list into a scatter diagram with age on the horizontal axis and the number of people of a certain age on the vertical axis, and it will make a bell curved shape. A bell curve is perfectly symmetrical with respect to a vertical line through its peak and is sometimes called a Gauss curve or a normal curve. Now let us assume that we have recorded ages and computed the mean and standard deviation of these ages, and the mean age came out as 40 years and the standard deviation as 6 years, and the following can be said about the individual data, which in this case are the ages. At least 75% of all the ages will lie in the range of x bar plus minus of 2 into s, and s stands for standard deviation. In our case, it means that at least 75% of the people will have an age in the range of 40 plus minus 2 into 6, which is equal to 40 plus minus 12, which simplifies to a range of 28 to 52 years. That is, if we put the value of k as 2 in 1 minus 1 upon k square, then we get 1 minus 1 upon 2 square, which is equal to 0.75, which implies that 75% of the observations will lie between mean minus k into standard deviation to mean plus k into standard deviation. So 75% of the observations will lie between mean, that is 40, minus k, that is 2, into standard deviation, which is equal to 6, which gives 28, to 40 plus 2 into 6, which is equal to 52. And then we have at least 88.9% of all the ages will lie in the range of 6 bar plus minus of 3 into standard deviation, that is s. In our case, it means that at least 88.9% of the people will have an age in the range of 40 plus minus 3 into 6, which is equal to 40 plus minus of 18, which simplifies to a range of 22 to 58 years. At least 93.75% of all the ages will lie in the range of 4 plus minus of 4 into standard deviation s. In our case, it means that at least 93.75% of the people will have an age in the range of 40 plus minus of 4 into 6, which is equal to 40 plus minus of 24, which simplifies to a range of 16 to 64 years. And similarly, we can say that at least 96% of all the ages will be in the range of mean x bar plus minus of 5 into s, that is the standard deviation. And in this case, it means that at least 96% of the people will have an age in the range of 40 plus minus of 5 into 6, which is equal to 40 plus minus of 30, which simplifies to a range of 10 to 70 years. Now we shall learn how to calculate these percentages. Now, to calculate the 75%, the 88.9%, the 93.75%, etc. We look at the number of standard deviations. In the respective intervals, the 75% goes together with mean plus minus of 2 into standard deviation . 88.9% goes together with mean plus minus of 3 into standard deviation. The 93.75% goes with mean plus minus of 4 into standard deviation. So in general, we can say that the percentage of people with an age in the range of 3 plus minus of k times standard deviation can be found by calculating the value of the quantity 1 minus 1 upon k square and then by converting that into a percentage . Summarizing the above, we get the following table. We should note that we can take any value of k as long as it is larger than 1. For example, for k is equal to 2.5, we get the result that 1 minus 1 upon 2.5 the whole square, which is equal to 0.84 or 84% in the interval 40 plus minus of 2.5 into 6, which is equal to 40 plus minus of 15 years. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.